This is match game 76. Show number 820. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Ruff. Lee Meriwether. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game 76. And now here's the star of match game 76, Gene Rivers.
Don't do that. Hello, Johnny Olson. How are you?
Good.
How are you there? Look at all of these beautiful people here.
I am the Indian princess.
You are the Indian princess.
That part's going to be cut out in Philly.
I see. You're a border taxi, eh?
See.
It looks more like a borderline case to me. Vroom chop. What is that? All right. Take me to Tijuana. Oh, look at the zebra.
No, I'm referee.
Oh, you're the referee.
Umpire.
You're the umpire. There. Hello. All right. Ready?
Yep.
Okay, let's say hello to two players, Evelyn Collins, Patricia Van Dyke. Here we go.
How much money do you want altogether?
$15,550.
$15,550, and you said if you win that much, you're going to take your husband on vacation to New York.
Right.
You're going to stay someplace fancy, and you're going to live it up, right? Now, what would you expect to do for laughs in New York City, to have a gay, wonderful time?
I'll visit his family. They're full of laughs. Yes, you know.
Well, having a wonderful time, wish you were there. So, here we are. Where are we? In the middle of round two. You've had your two questions, right?
Yes, right.
And now you're going to keep your fingers crossed.
Toes, too.
And toes, too. And all you have to do is match one to tie and two to win. And that'll be your seventh, will it?
Oh, yes.
Seventh game. Well, we're going steady, aren't we, Evelyn?
I hope so.
All right, see how this game turns out right after we see about this.
The party rolls on as Game Show Network celebrates 30 years of Match Game with 30 episodes back-to-back. Stay tuned.
We're ready to carry on here, finish this game. Second half of round two, final round. Evelyn, it's all yours. Remember, one to tie and two to win. Everyone except Charles will play. Charles, you lay out, okay?
See.
Little Ralphie is a tough little kid. Instead of sleeping with a teddy bear, Ralphie sleeps with a blank. Ralphie's a tough little kid. Instead of sleeping with a teddy bear, Ralphie sleeps with a blank.
You're so butch.
Yes, I am.
You're so macho. You drive me crazy.
All right.
No, he drive you crazy. I've
seen spots before my eyes.
You're seeing spots before your eyes?
When I'm finishing. Would you believe this was a white blouse when I started?
What was yours?
It's taking a long time to do that, huh?
Richard helped me.
Oh, there's spots. You see spots before your eyes now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Gene.
What? Goodbye, cruel world.
Instead of sleeping with a teddy bear,
I'm a little slow.
Little Ralphie is. Should I read it for him? Maybe
I got it. I got it. Boy, I'm real fast. Boy, am I fast enough?
Goodness gracious. Come on, Bill.
All right, answer. Wrong, but...
Come on now. Stop that. Little Ralphie is a tough little kid. Instead of sleeping with a teddy bear, Ralphie sleeps with a blank.
A live bear.
A live bear. A live bear. She said, what do you say, Bill?
I can't believe she said that. I pulled that out of the last second. I said a real bear.
A real bear. Yeah. So now we got a tie score. One more live bear will win the game for Evelyn, her seventh game.
Do you remember the muttering? You said, hush. I said, you're cute answer. Wrong, but cute.
What's yours?
I said, now I'm embarrassed. I said, gun.
Gun is all right. He's telling me he sleeps with a gun. What do you say? You don't play.
See.
Right. What do you say, Lee?
Well,
you play? You
really
say see?
He was really a rough kid. I said machine gun.
Machine gun. Tough little kid, instead of sleeping with a teddy bear, Ralphie sleeps with a...
grizzly bear.
Bear!
Grizzly bear! Evelyn wins the game.
Yeah.
Okay, hang around over there. Patricia, there'll be lots of gifts coming your way.
I had a beautiful time.
I'm glad you did. Patricia Van Dyke, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. How do you feel?
Great.
Now you got 15,650.
Right.
And you know, if you go all the way here and win the whole bundle, you could go over $20,000. One of the few people to have gone that far on this show.
We'd all go all the way, I think.
Sure. For $20,000. That's right.
I've been marked down for 5 years.
We polled a recent studio audience, my dear. We got their best response to this. Snap blank. Now, the answer they gave, remember, is worth $500 to you if you match it, and $250 if you hook up with the second most popular answer, and then $100 for the third most popular answer. Now, pick them out here one by one, Evelyn.
Charles, please.
Hi, sweetheart. Snapdragon.
Snapdragon?
Richard.
The illegitimate cereal. Snap, crackle, and no pop.
Okay.
Ready?
And Betty.
Snap judgment.
Snap judgment. So there they are. Snap judgment, snap, crackle, pop, and snap dragon. You may have one of those. Have you thought it over?
Yes.
Have you made a decision?
Yes,
have you got your own?
No.
You want one of these?
Yes.
Which one?
Charles. Snap dragon.
Snap dragon. Okay. Let's see, we got a Snapdragon up there. Earl, may we see the $100 number? Snap judgment is Betty White's answer. All right, we are still looking for that beautiful, fragrant flower, a Snapdragon. May we see the $250 number? Yes, we got it. Congratulations, Evelyn. Pick up another $250, you got $15,900. What you think is on a big one there? Snap, crackle, pop?
Snap fingers.
Do you think that it is there?
I think it is.
How come you didn't say it?
Because I thought dragon would be up there.
Okay.
Snap fingers.
Slide it, Earl. Snap, crackle, and pop. All righty. Now you're going to play for 10 times at $250 or $2,500. And remember, you got to match one exactly in order to collect. Whom do you call out?
I'm going with Charles again.
All right, Charles, get set, and here we go. It's worth $2,500. And it'll put her over 17,000 by 18,000 by a long shot.
You're blank. A good little subtractor, but you're a lousy ass.
Blank shave. Blank shave. Charles is thinking it over very carefully. He's finally given us an answer, and we watch your answer now, which you think will match his. Blank shave.
Close shave.
Close shave. Okay, Charles. She says close shave will match you for $2,500. That's a bridge.
Good.
Right.
Because if she keeps it up, she'll probably, when she goes to New York, buy the Brooklyn Bridge. Close.
Close shave.
Atta girl, Evelyn.
Yeah, you got $18,400 there. And we'll come back and introduce your new player in a moment or so, but right now, these messages just for you. Here we go. Ready? Would you all give a brisk round of applause, please,
Why
to
not?
Our new player, Debbie Coden.
Hello, Debbie.
Where are you from?
La Mirada.
Colorado?
La Mirada.
La Mirada.
Uh-huh.
Never heard of that. Where is that?
Well, it's not
nearby?
Too far. Yes.
But it's in the Los Angeles area somewhere.
Yes, it's close to Downey.
Oh, yes. Aren't we all? What do you do, if anything?
I am a mother and a wife. I have 3 children, and they're a lot of fun.
I have 2. It just seems like 30.
Oh. You have pretty teeth.
Thank you.
What do you do for that?
Fresh?
After every meal.
Isn't she clever? Comes up with these snappy answers there. What's your kids' names?
I'll start with D.
Really?
Juliet, Darren, and Dana.
Uh-huh.
And my husband's name also begins with D, Dennis.
Dennis. Mm-hmm.
So okay. Does don't.
All right, Debbie, are you ready, my dear? You have a choice here. You may have A or B.
B.
Okay. You rascal, you. Here we go. Weird Willie lost his job as a hospital orderly when they caught him sticking a drinking straw in a blank.
What?
Weird Willie.
Now, we've got
now, the first round questions are tough. They're kind of wide open. Almost
yes,
any answer is possible.
I know that.
Weird Willie lost his job as a hospital orderly when they caught him sticking a drinking straw in a blank. Charles is ready. It was easy for him.
Charles is ready. Well, I've got to.
You can't think of anything?
Not a thing. Is that terrible?
You will. Something will come to you.
I don't want to say that.
It'll come to you.
Okay. That's all right. Fine. That's all right.
It's my dumb day. I'm a lot. I'm a guest. Sure.
All right. Anything. What do you say? All right. Weird Willie, Debbie, lost his job as a hospital orderly when they caught him sticking a drinking straw in a blank.
A blood sample?
A blood sample. That's okay. That's not a bad answer at all. Don't boo that answer, whoever booed that answer. That's okay. What do you say, Bill?
Well, assuming he's not a urologist, I said test tube. Would that be close?
A test tube is all right, but not necessarily any blood in there. She said a blood sample.
Hi, hon.
Hello, darling. You can't read your writing?
Well,
you don't want to read it.
I don't... Well, I mean, it's just sometimes you're just embarrassed. I said in the navel of a dead
horse. The navel of a corpse.
You know, I think I like her better now. I think we're going to have a nice time tonight. I think it's going to work out all
Come
right.
Come on, Charles. Charles. Are you angry?
No.
Oh. What is that?
For you medical students, it is a drawing of my answer. We recommend a 20cc bottle.
Specimen.
Oh. No, I pass on that one. Okay. Well, they caught him sticking a drinking straw in a blood sample, according to her. What do you say?
Mine hurts almost as much as Brett's.
What? Now, wait a minute.
A patient's nose.
Oh.
I couldn't feel anything to write. Yet.
Bring us back to sanity, Richard.
Well, I didn't actually name the physician. I just said a patient.
In a patient, right. Okay, Betty?
I would have come up with the correct answer if Richard had not torn my cards in half, which makes it very difficult to play.
Oh, very difficult.
It's an economy drive. We're trying to save money.
Oh, he was making a comment on the kind of half answers I give. So that's why I said specimen bottle. It had nothing to do with it.
Specimen bottle. Don't be ashamed to say it. Don't try and pass over it. We all heard you say specimen bottle. Okay, that's the end of that. Now, let's get on. Evelyn, you ready?
I'm ready.
Oh, we're not ready. Okay. We're going to do a commercial here, okay. And then we're going to come back to you. So pay attention to this and hurry back.
More Match Game Marathon coming your way. Stay tuned.
Ready and ready to go here. Ready, Evelyn? Now we're ready for it. All right, now listen to this, Evelyn, my dear. Here it is. Before Harry went out on his date with Gloria, he put on a nurse's outfit. Uh-oh. Because he heard that Gloria just adored men in blank. That's it.
It is exactly what you...
Right. Oh, yes. Right.
But
it.
Would you read the question again? Because I may have misinterpreted it.
Before Harry went out on his date with Gloria, he put on a nurse's outfit because he heard that Gloria just adored men in blank. You did misinterpret it?
I did misinterpret it. That's so unusual.
What you gonna do now?
For me, I usually don't write.
Okay, all right. Okay. Come over here to Evelyn Collins and ask her to respond. Before Harry went out on his date with Gloria, he put on a nurse's outfit because he heard that Gloria just adored men in...
white.
Men in white. Okay. Wait a minute now. It may not be a thigh slapper, but it was one of two really good answers. What do you say?
I thought it was extremely hilarious. White.
White. Men in white.
I was holding back the laughter on that, but I like that.
What did you do? You tore up Men in White, did you?
No. Now, what is the other good answer?
Well, let me see if you've got it first.
Wait a minute.
What are you doing?
Uniforms?
Yeah.
Oh, I said white.
White.
It was uniforms, I
men, is it men in uniform or men in white are the two really good answers there. What do you say, Charles?
I could have stuck with uniform.
Well, I kept in the tradition of our show.
Yes.
Which is blank.
Right.
So I answered in French.
Blanc.
Men in blanc.
Blanc is white. Very good. Clever. Very clever fellow there.
Wasn't that clever?
Yes.
No.
Put on a nurse's outfit because you heard that Gloria just adored men in white. What do you say to that, Lee Meriwether?
Well, I was really dumb. I tore up white. I didn't tear it up, but I had uniform.
Well, uniform and white were the two good ones. I dare say that Richard would have one of those two because
I wish I had a white uniform. I just have a uniform.
White uniform would have scored there. Betty?
I think that's why he put the outfit on in the first place. But listen, I'm going to change my name to Betty Blanc.
Oh! Betty Blanc. There we are. End of round one. It's 4-0 in favor of Evelyn. Debbie, you may have A or B again.
That's right, A.
A? B wasn't so good for you, huh?
No.
Okay. Marvin got stranded on a desert island with Ugly Edna.
Oh.
As soon as Marvin took one look at her, he started blanking. Marvin got stranded on a desert island with Ugly Edna. As soon as he took one look at her, he started blanking.
Actually, that construction is loud. As soon... Well, it's bad. Reconstruct that sentence, darling, so it is.
Marvin got stranded on a desert island with Ugly Edna. As soon as Marvin took a look at her, he started blanking. There's nothing wrong with that at all. Perfect grammar.
It should be a look, not one look.
No, that's a colloquial expression. Ready, Debbie? Don't say it yet. Let me give it to you one more time. Marvin got stranded on a desert island with Ugly Edna. As soon as Marvin took one look at her, he started blanking.
Throwing up.
Well. let's see what you say, Bill.
I'm sorry. That was a good one, though. I'm sorry. I said started crying. Small applause, but that's all right.
What do you say, Brett?
I believe I have the definitive answer.
What is that?
Swimming.
That's it. You heard it. Now, Debbie, you have to match all four remaining ones to stay in the game and achieve a tie. If you don't, Evelyn will win her eighth game. Charles?
Uh-oh. I won't let her down. Heaving.
Heaving. There it is. There's one for you. All right, Lee, we're up to you. 4-1 the score. What do you say?
I'm sorry. Swimming was...
Swimming. And Evelyn wins the game. Come on down, Evelyn. There you are. Okay. Gee, Debbie, sorry to see you go. It was a very short meeting, but a very pleasant one. We do have some gifts for you, which will come to you. Where are you going? Debbie, I'm not finished talking to you yet. Debbie, what are you doing here? I dare you walk out. I'm a star, Debbie. You can't walk out of me like this. Oh, Debbie. Harding is what sweet... Oops! Hello, Earl. Earl, what are you doing in there all alone? You left. Hello there, folks. Go to black.
G. Gene and the gang will be back with more Match Game Marathon right after this.
How much time? 35 seconds. Is that all? 35-second segment.
All right, folks. Here we are. Just want to say goodbye. Goodbye. Tell you all how swell you were.
Aw, thanks.
You were really swell.
Good gravy, Marie.
And I want to thank you. Come to the dressing room after the show, okay? Listen, next week, we're going to have a lot more fun because these are the bodies who will be on this very stage. Fun?
Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Dee Dee Khan. Richard Dawson. And Patty Doyle.
I meant to say next time, whatever that is. Could be Tuesday or Thursday or Friday or whatever. Gene Meriwether, join us next time for Match Game 76. Goodbye.